So guys, we'll speak about the speedo console of the Apache RR310. A lot has been said about this instrumentation console. It's completely digital, looks quite nice and does showcase a lot of things. So to begin with, the lower part shows you the gear. Currently we are in neutral and the side stand is on, so that's also a good indication. This is the engine temperature. Obviously the bike is cold right now, so it's towards C, which is cold. Next up is the fuel gauge, then is the time. It's not set properly right now, so please excuse me for this wrong timing. This is the complete distance the bike has done till now, which is 1163. On the right side of this, you see the tachometer. Slightly difficult to read when you're moving, but the speedo is quite big, quite large. And this shows what menu you are in right now. So this is the basic odometer, and hence it's written odo over here. From here you can change and toggle between the various modes. If I press this, we go into the range, which you can see 78 right now because the fuel is quite less. Pressing this again, we go into the immediate fuel economy, IMI. Of course the bike is off right now, so it is not showcasing, but this is a good way to see how much the bike is delivering at a given speed in a given gear. This is the overall fuel economy, and hence we have the average indicator over here. I'm getting 33 kmpl, which is phenomenal for a bike of this size and power. In fact, this is more than my own Aprilia SR150cc scooter, which I use in Delhi. Next up is the total fuel that the bike has consumed till now, 42.5 liters. And this can be reset, which I have gone to zero now. Next up is the trip meters. We have two trip meters, 1 and 2, and you have A as well. This is the total distance I've ridden so far in the given tank range. I had reset the trip meter to take out the fuel economy. Trip 2 is also same. This is trip A. And then you came to the high speed factor. This is something I did a few days back on the Yamuna Expressway. Now I am over 100 kgs, and yet with my weight, the bike managed a cool 164, which is quite nice for a 310cc motor. This is the average speed I've been getting. Of course, I was on the highway and then inside city limits, so average speed is quite high, 58 kilometers per hour. This is the temperature of the bike right now, the engine, 45.5, of course, because the bike is just standing right now, it's not on. In traffic, it goes to 105, 110, but once you start moving, it comes down under 100. This is the overspeed setting, which we can do currently at 160. And acceleration, again with my weight on the Yamuna Expressway, a cool 3.1 seconds. And as I understand, after watching the videos, the 0 to 100 timing was somewhere around 6.5 seconds, which we'll be uploading on the YouTube channel. This is the total time I've ridden the bike since the reset, 4 hours 12 minutes. Again, if I keep pressing this, it goes to 0. Date has to be set, so this is the wrong date right now. This is for lap use, as you can see, lap timer, but not for city usage. And lap information, again, not for city usage. And finally, the setup mode, where if I keep pressing this, I can go into the setup mode and change the date and time, as you can see right now. But I'll do that later on, so I'll just reset the ignition. Yeah, so quite comprehensive. It's difficult to read. Only the tachometer part is difficult to read because of the numbers are very small. Otherwise, it's a nice display. Also, by using this button, you can put on the hazard lights, which you'll see right here come on. So the indicators just start blinking. Good if you are parked by the side of the road. This is the ABS light, which will go off when you start the bike, the neutral light. This again, the engine light goes off when you, once you start the bike. Even this light goes off once you start the bike.